We read verse 1.
Reto kumana palali nchumo wikenya Exodus chapter 33 verse 1. Yona geri humane ere. Morena oboleche le moshe are. Sepela uhuduefa ona lesichavasi. Se usinchiche na renya kepeta le na renyela yeki enetiro Abrahama li Isaka li Jacobo kare. Kito efa bana bagao. Kito Roma morongwa waka aweta pili. Karaka ba kanana le ba moro le ba hete le ba peresi le ba lifi le ba jebusi ke kwa na genyela yela go maswi le dinosi ka go ba nna se ke o ka go ba nna nka se ke kaya ke le magatheng a lena kare le she le se chaba sa melala e methata gore ke se tlo le fetsa tseleng.
Verse 7, yes. And we go down to, yeah, read from verse 7, then I will stop.
Verse 7, bele moshe a thutha ngwakola a o tloma ka ntle ga mishasha khujana le mishasha a o rea lena la ngwako wa kgwerana ya ba gore e anya ka go morena a tswele ngwakong wa kgwerana a tswele ya ba gore e anya ka go morena a tswe tswile ngwakong wa kgwerana o bego ona o le ka ntle ga mishasha moshe re a fela a tswela ngwakong owe se tshaba ka moka sebesi tsoge motho a eme mo Jakong wa mokutwana wa gagwe a lebeletse moshe abe a fitlhe ngwakong owe ebe ire ge moshe a tsena mo ngwakong o le rula thololo le fologe le eme mo Jakong wa ngwako mme morena a bolele le moshe gomme setšhaba ka moka ga sona sa bona le rula thololo le eme mo Jakong wa ngwako setšhaba ka moka sa ema motho a khunama mo Jakong wa mokutwana wa gago morena o be a bolela le moshe ba lebane difatlhego bjalo ka ge monna a bolela le morwarrago gomme moshe ge a boela mešašeng go a šala Joshua morwa wa Nunu modiredi wa gagwe wa lesogana a se tloge mo ngwakong gomme moshe o boletše le morena a re bjale o mpuditše wa re iša setšhaba kua mme wa lesa go mpotša yo o tlogo moroma a ya le nna le ge o itse ke go tseba ka leina mme ke go lebeletse ka botho bjale ge o ntebeletse ka botho gona ntsebiše tsela ya gago tlhe gore ke go tsebe ge o fela o ntebeletse ka botho gomme batho a ko fele o ba dira setšhaba sa gago morena a re nna ka noši ke tlo sepela le wena ka go goroša.
Amen. Verse 15
e re moshe a re ge wena ka noši o sa e le rena gona o se ke wa re lesa ra tloga fa.
Hold it right there. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus. My God, we thank you for the reading of your word. Heavenly Father, speak to us. Correct us, O God. Heavenly Father, through your word, we pray in the name of Jesus. Here are your people. Speak to them, Lord God. We pray and we have listened. Father God, in your word, we love you and bless your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. I will be speaking under this title. Dwell in the presence of God. Dwell in the presence of God. The Bible says God spoke to Moses. Leave this place and go to the place where I have promised to you. The land of promise. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God has promised the Israelites that after they've been rescued from Egypt, they will go to the promised land that God has promised his forefathers, Abraham and Jacob. And God is saying this to Moses and said, leave this place and go to the promised land. And I, the Lord, I will be with you. And whatever that will be the hindrance on your way, I will remove it. I will send an angel from above to remove it and everything that will disturb you to reach the promised land. Child of God, if God promised you that he is going to take you to a certain place, he knows that there are some of the things that will disturb you to reach your promised land. He knows that the devil will not like that. He will try by all means to disturb you to reach what God has promised you. Because God is a faithful God, he promised Moses that whatever that will hinder you, I will remove it so that you can go freely to the land that I have promised you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now the Bible says, Moses pitched the tent, the house of the covenant. And the house of the covenant is whereby Moses, when he is inside, he prayed to God that, God, because you have promised us that you will be with us, I need you to show us that you are with us.
Moshe abolala le modimo are o bana ona le rena re duma o re o bona re na le rena.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the Bible says,
Bibele iri,
when Moses was inside the house of God,
Bibele iri ge Moshe le ka ngwakong wa kgorana,
when he prayed to God,
a rapela modimo,
the Bible says,
Bibele iri,
The pillar of the cloud will show up. And when the Israelites see the pillar of the cloud hovering around, they know that the presence of the Lord is with us. The God that we serve, the God that has rescued us from the Egyptians, He is with us.
Amen.
And they made sure that they don't depart from the house of the Lord. Because at times God will come with the pillar of the cloud.
Hey.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And Moses said to the Lord, Father, if it is you, what is it that they will convince us that you are God, you are still with us?
Hey.
What is it, God, that you promised us that will show that definitely you are moving with us? God said to to Moses, because I am the Lord your God, I have promised you that I will never leave you nor forsake you. God said to Moses, what is it? What was something that will convince you that I am the Lord? My presence as the Lord will be with you. Hey.
Amen.
And Moses said, Lord, don't let us go without your presence. We cannot make it. We cannot make it without your presence. We need your intervention. We need your power to walk with us. If you cannot walk with us, don't let us to leave this place. Because he realized that he cannot do it by his own strength. He cannot make it by his physical strength, but he needed the intervention of the power of God. He needed the intervention of the presence of God so that they can go forward, so that they can go forward and serve him and worship his name. They needed the presence of God.
Amen.
Child of God, don't find yourself walking alone. Don't find yourself walking down the road being alone. You need the intervention of the power of God. We need the intervention of the Holy Spirit just to give you strength, because this road that we're walking in has lot of obstacles, have a lot of hindrances. Therefore, you cannot make it on your own, but you need the presence of God just to walk with you.
Amen.
Lord, if you are not with us, do not let us go. Lord, if you are not with us, do not let us go. If the presence of God is not around you, don't take a step. If the presence of God is not with you, If the clouds of God is not hovering around you, don't ever take the step to walk. Because the devil is roaming like a lion, looking for someone to devour. If we can take the step without the presence of God, the devil will be able to tear you out.
Hey. Amen.
Let the presence of God hover around your life. Let the presence of God take control of your life. You cannot make it by your physical strength. You cannot make it by your mental strength. But we need the Lord to intervene.
Hey.
There are some of the servants of God that they realized that the situation that they find themselves in, they cannot make it on their own. Remember Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, when they were lake in the lake of fire, they realized that on our own we cannot make it. But God, if God is with us, we can make it. When they throw them inside the lake of fire, the presence of God intervene. When they thought that the fire has destroyed them, somebody immersed inside the lake of fire. Hey. They said, now we have thrown three men inside the lake of fire, but we can see the fourth man that is moving in the fire. Who is that man? That man was the presence of God. That man was the presence of God to take care of this servant. Hallelujah to God. Some of the situations, they need the intervention of God. Some of the situations, they need the power of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You have been struggling a lot in your life. Some of the things they don't go away. Why? Because you are doing it on your own. You are doing it on your own. That is why the situation they don't change. It is time to invite God. It is time to let God to take care of the situation. It is time to let God to intervene into your program, and you will see the grace of God. When Daniel was in the den of the in the pit of lions, he knew that he cannot make it on his own. He needed the intervention of God. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
When he was inside the den of lions, the presence of God came down. and moved around the lions because he trusted God for the intervention in the difficulties that he find himself in. Hallelujah to God. Paul and Silas, when they were in jail, they faced the difficulties. They walked around. They started to worship the Lord. They started to sing the songs of praise. They started to worship the Lord. And the glory of the Lord came down. The glory of the Lord intervened in their situation until the jailer said, I think they are God. They said, yeah, we are not God. We are here. Don't kill yourself. The situation, the presence of God intervened. Lord, if we cannot go with us, don't let us go. If you don't walk with us, don't let us go. Hallelujah. We need the intervention of God as we worship the Lord, as we are in the house of worship. We need the intervention of God. Otherwise, we'll just come into the church and go back the same. Because the presence of God is not here. We must always cry for the presence of God. We don't have to be the religious people, but we must be the people with full of the power of God. We must be the people who are full of the grace of God, who are full of the power of the Holy Spirit. When you start to pray, when you start to talk to the Lord, whatever that is surrounding you, whatever that is disturbing you to serve the Lord, because you are in the presence of God, they will go away. They will go away. The demons that are hindering your life, that are tormenting your children, as long as the presence of God is here, they will go away. Hallelujah. It doesn't help to come to the church, sing the choruses, we dance before the Lord without the presence of God. It doesn't help. It doesn't help at all. We need the intervention, the power of the Holy Spirit.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Somebody said, you cannot come into contact with the Lord and remain the same. As long as the presence of God is here, you cannot move out of this place the same. You will move out of this place full of the power of God, full of the presence of God. When you go out there, you're going to face challenges, and you will be able to fight, you will be able to conquer, because you are full of the presence of God.
Obano tletse ka bogona ba morena.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There are so many things that are happening outside there that will hinder you to serve God. That will hinder you to serve God fully. Therefore, you need God to intervene. Hallelujah.
Amen.
One of the singers said, in your presence, Lord, I want to be. That is where I want to be. In your presence, oh God. That is where I want to be. Hallelujah.
Yes.
I don't want to walk around without you.
No.
I need you in my life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Paul said, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. He realized that he cannot do anything on his own, but he need God to be there so that he can do whatever he wants to do. Hey, child of God, you need the power of God to do greater things. The devil is a liar.
Satan
ekiramaka. The devil is a liar.
Satan ekiramaka.
We need God.
Re tlhoka Modimo.
More than anything.
Go feta tjotjo.
We need God.
Re tlhoka
Modimo. More than anything.
Go feta tjotjo.
We don't need things that can be touchable. No, we don't need water. We need the presence of God. We need the presence of God. If we can hold on to God, everything will be possible. We don't need the things that can be touched. We don't need the oils. We don't need that. No. We need the presence of God.
Amen.
Yes,
Lord.
We need the presence of God. We need the presence of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are tired, man. We are tired to be in the house of the Lord without the presence of God. It is high time that we cry before the Lord and said, Lord, remember us. Remember us. We need your presence. We need your intervention in your house.
Oh. Yes, Lord.
Oh. If the presence of God is not with us, the Satanists will move around the church. The Satanists will play around the church. If the presence of God is not here, yeah, child of God, you need the presence of God. Oh, Rabo Sataria Bamos. The devil is a liar.
Satan ekiramaka.
The devil is a liar.
Satan ekiramaka.
We'll be on fire for God. 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 We'll be on fire for God.
Yes, Lord.
Yay.
Yes, Jesus.
Lambroshakata. Lembre shalabos. You're not to be in the presence of God. It helps us to understand God. It helps us to understand God. It helps us to understand the weight of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To be in the presence of God, help us to understand the weight of God. To be in the presence of God, help us to be strong in faith. To be in the presence of God, help us to be brave in the Lord. Because God has said, I didn't give you the spirit of fear, but I have given you the spirit of power. But we cannot experience that power unless we are in the presence of God. Hallelujah. I don't know what you are going through in life. I don't know what kind of situation you find yourself in. Just let God to intervene in the situation. You will see God do opening doors. You will see God doing miracles. You will see God doing amazing things. As long as we allow God to intervene. I like this statement when Moses said, if you don't go with us, if you don't go with us, don't go, don't let us go. Babang barna rotsena tseleng ra sepila rai no ikena le mengwa ngwa ke le mo bukresteng a tseke dikilo nyana tseli nyane. Hey, be careful of what you are saying.
Tlokomela so se bolela.
Because once you are out of the presence of God, the devil is using that opportunity to destroy your life once and for all. The devil is not happy because you belong to God. He's not happy. He knows that you are making, a damage in his kingdom. He is not happy about that. So you need the power of God to make more damage in his kingdom. Yes, we need the power of God to make a great damage in his kingdom. And we enlarge the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. I heard one of the intercessors here in the morning said, at times we feel tired when we are supposed to pray. And he said, it is because some of the Satanists are with us in the service. Yes. Because the Satanists, they've been sent out to the churches so that they can make a damage in the kingdom of God. You cannot see them if you don't pray. We cannot see them unless we are in the presence of God. But if the presence of God is with us, we will be able to discern the spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We will be able to discern the spirit. When people are worshipping here, the demons will just scream because the presence of God is here. You see, worship is not an entertainment. Worship is not an entertainment. When we worship the Lord, we invite the presence of God to come. God said to the Israelites that let them walk around the walls of Jericho 7 times. He wanted to show them that when his presence is around, everything is possible. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When Jehoshaphat was facing the wall, God said to him, take the worshippers up front. Let them sing and worship. And you will see that the Israelites will win. The Israelites will be victorious because there are worshippers up front. That is why I'm saying, when we worship the Lord, it is not an entertainment. We don't get entertained, but we are provoking the power of God to come down. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hey people, when we worship the Lord, worship the Lord with all of your hearts, knowing that you provoke the power of God to come down.
Amen.
You must understand that. Worship is not a child's play. It is a great service. It's a mighty service, worshiping the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is why this singer said, when the praises go up, the glory of the Lord come down. When we worship the Lord, the presence of God come down. Everything that we do in the presence of God, we must be serious about it. When you pray in the house of the Lord, pray being serious. Because prayer is not something that you can pray about. When you enter into the prayer, you know that I'm entering into a war. I provoke the power of God to come down. When the house of the Lord is full of fire, even the demons cannot enter in that door. They will be burned by the fire of the living God. We need that God. We need that God. that intervened into the lake of fire. We need that God that intervened in the presence of Paul and Silas. We need that God that the rescued Daniel in the pit of lions. We need that God. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. The same God that Moses was praying. The same God that Moses was worshipping. He is the same God that we are worshipping even today. He is unchangeable. Oye mijwalo. Oye mijwalo is yena. Ditaba di so bophi. Ayama jwalo ile modimo.
Yes, Jesus.
Esaliela setshabelo. Esaliela bukhuto ba rona. Ke saliela modimo. Ha fetori. O bone ke ta feta. Are ga ke dutsi. Mo ke phebelwang ke yena. Ke lala moritong a yo matla. Ka re bona o setshabelo sa rena. O bukhuto ba rena. O modimo rena re motileng. O modimo rena re thagileng ka yena. We need his presence. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jehovah Shammah. Thank you, oh God. We need God. Shandorokoya. We need God. 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 Shatoria Hasha. We need God. We need God. My mother, you need God. My father, you need God.
Papa,
you need the intervention of God. In your family, you need God. Your children are not listening to you. Ooh. That situation needs God. There are some of the things that we have been praying for a long time. And you don't see the reports. That situation needs God. You cannot make it on your own. Some of the things they blocked in the spiritual realm. They need the intervention of God. When Daniel was praying, his prayers were blocked on the spiritual realm. Up until God sent an angel of war. And when the angel of war came, he said to Daniel, God heard your prayers. But there were some of the things that they were hindering your prayers. Child of God, we are praying. But some of our prayers are hindered in the spiritual realm. They are hindered in the spiritual realm. They need the intervention of the power of God. They need the intervention of God. Your miracle needs the intervention of God. Your miracle is about to come to you. But some of the things they've hindered your miracle. How many of you need the presence of God? We don't depend our own strength. We depend upon the power from above. We depend upon the power from above. David said, one thing that I've heard is that the power belongs to God. Power belongs to God. Power to release your miracle belongs to God. Power to pave whatever that is hindering the presence of God belongs to God. Power to heal your disease belongs to God.
Hey.
Hallelujah. The power to heal your diseases doesn't come from the prophets. They come from God. Therefore, you have to allow God to intervene in that situation. The woman with the issue of blood, she realized that I've used so many things. I have used money, but nothing helped. Up until she said, if I can allow God to intervene in my situation, things will be different. When Jesus was passing by, she touched the hem of his garment. And immediately after she did that, she was healed. That is why I'm saying some of the things they need the presence of God. Hallelujah. Jesus. I want to pray. You are here and you are facing difficulties. You have tried so many things. You did it on your own without inviting God. I encourage you this morning that if you can allow God to intervene in that situation, you will see the result. You will see some wonders. things that seems to be impossible. Before the eyes of the Lord, they are possible. They need the intervention of God. Don't let yourself go without the clouds that is hovering around the clouds of the presence of God. The Bible says when the Israelites were walking in the night, God was leading them with a star. And during the day, God was leading them with a cloud. You need God to intervene in your situation. Just allow Him to touch that situation. Things will never be the same. Allow Him to touch you. Allow the hand of God to touch you. You will never be the same. Kimulele titsietsi senkhatata sale fatsi kiruletso fetsegona likuno tu lemorena. Rula tsohle bohoneng ba modimo go se. Rula tsohle tete go imelang se. Ti rula bohoneng ba modimo. O ske wa di rula la batho. Ti rula la bohoneng ba modimo. Molala tsedi go khathatsa. Ti di sa go roba tsimbushego. Molala tsona. He will intervene. Kar audi ti audi rola la batho batho ba ile di tlatsana ga ye ka moka mara di tse o di rola le go yena yena o ya tse ba o tla fetula. Ka hore motho ke motho ke rola tso se hey Senkhatata salifatsi kiruletso setse runa likuno tu lemurena hona le mo kallelang hona hona le sekhutwana se o kaya mo sona. Tsholala morana tsedi leng ka rapelo yaka. Hey. Tsholala tsedi leng ka rapelo ya hao in the right place. Tsholala tsedi leng ka rapelo ya hao to the right God. Tsholala tsedi leng ka rapelo ya hao bo hona mpomorena and you will say the presence of God, you will see the mighty of God. Shh. tedeng tadilo dinya ka wadan le modi wa ke tsole la ka saka wa skoka tsukutlwaneng sa ha wa re modimo ke khale ke sepela ke niti ke sabono rna ke ya ka mara ke alemo wa hore modimo ha wana ulo hona mayemong ya tilo di tla fetu mocha are ke ngin thonka e bonang ya o tla etsa hore o modimo hare bo hona baka botla sepela le wena motswadi wa ka bo hona ba modimo botla sepela le wena bo hona ba modimo le ga ra ba ka skeba go batamela le ga dilo di ka sketsa hlakana ga botse mana bo hona ba modimo bo hona ba modimo ha bo le gona bo enough Salama, yeah. Shakotoria bossi. Motomung mudimu amolokola today. Motomung mudimu olokola molokola karamaya mas mahuona. Rakostaria ha salama. Limbrosta karia babosita. Limbra shalama handa bosse kete yama. Kiru lezo lezo una li kuno tu. Worshipers, help me please. Lemu rena kimu lele. Ditsiatsi tsengata tsa le fatsi ke ro letso letse rona le kuno tu le mo rena ke molele ke mulele jitsi yati senkha tsatsa tsole fatsi kiru letso letse runa le kunoti le Kimulele, kimulele, jiti yati, tsengata, sale fati, kirule tsohle, tsohle tsehona, likunyunoti. Sidi ba se khuduwe